So that's where we are in the here and now with this week-long saga of Senator Mitchell. But what does it all mean? Political strategist Brian McClung is here. And let's just get to the big question here, Brian. Democrats aren't calling her to pack up and go. Is that because they are backing due process or because of the politics involved, meaning they need her vote to get to that one over the hill?
Well, you know, Jana, it's really shocking to all of your viewers that there's politics happening at the state capitol. So right. I think when it comes down to it, it is that one seat majority, 34 to 33. And so Democrats need Senator Mitchell to pass their agenda. So I understand that their calls for due process are well-founded, right? I mean, she should have due process, but you can have that both in the court of law and in the Senate, and you could speed up that ethics process if you wanted. So that's where there's really some friction happening.
So why not pressure on her by the Democratic leadership to resign? They want that vote that bad?
Well, I think so. I mean, and ultimately, you know, we just have less than 1 month left in this legislative session. But that's when all the stuff happens. That's when a bonding bill comes together. That's when you could see sports gambling. That's when you could see a fix on ride sharing. That's when you could see, you know, other important issues come together, like improvements on the cannabis law. And so this is really when you need all of your votes. And so it's no surprise the Senate Democrats want to do that. Republicans, though, pointed out that she was the deciding vote on whether or not she should be allowed to vote. And I think there is irony to that. I think a lot of Minnesotans will question, you know, should somebody who's been charged with a felony crime, mm-hmm. who was, you know, breaking into her stepmother's house dressed in all black at 4 o'clock in the morning, should somebody who took those kinds of actions be allowed to serve in the Senate? And we should hold our legislators to a higher standard.
And you've been involved in Minnesota politics far longer than I have. I can't remember. I mean, we've had sitting House members and Senate members charged with things like DWI and things like that. Nothing quite like felony burglary. So let's put the shoe on the other foot. You worked for Tim Pawlenty, Republican administration. If the Republicans were in the same place at a one-seat majority, would they tell their party member to resign?
Yeah, I think it depends on the circumstances, obviously, and every case is different. This is a really unique set of circumstances. You know, and I've been looking back, and I started working at the Capitol in 1997. That was just after there were two legislators who resigned from Painesville, brothers who were in the House and Senate, Joe and Jeff Bertram, mm-hmm. one accused of mistreating his constituents and bullying them, and one who was accused of shoplifting. And that person accused of shoplifting, that wasn't a felony,
right.
But ultimately that person did resign. So there have been some cases where lawmakers have resigned. I do think when the legislature is so closely divided, you'd see that pressure from either side to say, hey, let's kind of sort this out.
Well, it's politics in 2024, so buckle up. We've got a presidential election around the corner. Thanks so much, Brian.